given the last year against Auburn, and now you guys win two games like this, and the delays and the fun your team had in the clubhouse, was this one of the most memorable, you know, weekends so far of your career?
Well, you know, the weekend's not over, so as a coach, you know, we're already thinking about tomorrow night and what we need to do to prepare for a great Auburn team that I think is going to come out strong tomorrow. So by no means are we celebrating right now. I'm really proud of the way our kids have come out and played these two games. And, you know, everyone's going to look at the runs that were put up on the board. But the key to winning softball against good teams and winning this time of year is pitching and defense. And we've gotten two really good pitching performances and played solid defense.
Do you feel like you played some of your best softball today?
I think so, yeah. Again, it starts with pitching and defense. But the at-bats, I just told our team in all my years of coaching, I don't know if I've seen a team that had consistently so many quality at-bats. And that's when you can really have some big innings, is when you just hand the baton off and everybody goes up there with a real calm presence and has great pitch selection. And even if they don't get a hit, they do something productive with the at-bat because they're just trusting their eyes, seeing good pitches, and making sure that they, you know, swing at good pitches and stay in the strike zone. And that's what was most impressive to me today, was how consistently we did that throughout the day.
Two delays, but it didn't seem like it affected you guys at all. I guess, as a team, what goes into not being affected by long delays like that?
Well, I think the first thing you have to do is just kind of let them be loose during those delays. And so for about the first 20, 25 minutes, they just stayed in the dugout and listened to the music and sang along. And then once we knew that we were going to start play, about 10 minutes before that, we told them what the plan was and got them refocused and talked about how the game had ended and what had happened right there. And I thought we had taken our foot off the pedal a little bit in that third inning right before we had that lightning delay. So we talked about what we needed to do when the game started to, you know, keep our foot on the pedal and keep pushing offensively. And I was really pleased with how we did that when we got back up to bat in the fourth inning.
During practice leading up to these games, was the team more focused than normal because it's such a, you know, high-quality opponent? Or is this team just keeping the same mindset every practice, every week?
You know, I think they learned a lesson last week from Oklahoma about not focusing on the opponent too much and not thinking about past years and what's happened with that opponent and just focusing on themselves. But I really think it's just a culmination of things that we've worked on throughout the year. And maybe they're just finally kind of getting it and really seeing how it pays off. You know, if they take some of the lessons from practice into the game and really commit to them. So I think that's really more of it. And I think they also understand what's at stake. And, you know, we laid it out for them how they control their destiny. They control their destiny as far as getting an SEC bye, and they control their destiny as far as hosting a regional and getting a high enough RPI to be one of those top 16 teams. So they know what's at stake, and I think they're hungry for it.
I mean, Mark, you mentioned the SEC bye. I mean, you guys still have tomorrow and a whole other series next week. How much would that mean to know that you guys are third in the SEC right now?
Well, the SEC is the best conference in the country, and obviously every year you like to win the SEC championship, but I think to finish in the top four in this conference says a lot about your program and about your team, because how strong of a conference it is. Having that extra day off certainly helps, because to go through the SEC tournament, you know, playing three games to a championship instead of four makes a big difference. It can be done either way. But I think more than that, I think there's a lot of pride in finishing that high in a conference as tough as the SEC.